I'm Hannah, and last year I decided to do one of the biggest things I think I've ever done. I moved to West Africa. For the past couple of years, I have been reporting on stories specifically coming out of the continent. I'm really big on challenging stereotypes, especially when it comes to this side of the world. It's the biggest trip I've ever taken in my life, and I thought I'd bring you along on the journey with me. So, I decided to kick off this journey in Ghana. Now, a great place about Ghana is that I'm very familiar with it. The first time I went was 6 years ago, and since then, I've been going back and forth. The time of the year that I went was really exciting as well, because it was what the country's president announced to be the year of return. So, he encouraged so many people from within the diaspora to come back home. It was such a great time spent, connecting with friends, old and new, several nights turning into mornings, and never not having somewhere to go. And then we headed over to sweet, sweet Salon, Sierra Leone. Now for me personally, I feel like this is where the journey really began, because I was in completely unfamiliar surroundings, a new language, a new country essentially for me. And I'm so grateful for it.
Thank you. Nice. And you're making it today?
Yeah.
I'm excited.
I literally made friends with people that took me under their wing as family. Whether it was embracing and enjoying the beauty of the locals, the breathtaking beaches, the food, which literally changed my life. To be honest with you, Sierra Leone took a piece of my heart. Now, as you can imagine, for every traveller, especially a solo travelling female in West Africa, you're immediately pushed out of your comfort zone. And I guess going to Gambia next was testament to that. Didn't know crazy loads about the culture or the local languages, but was definitely ready to embrace it all.
A very unexpected solo beach afternoon for a couple of hours. Kind of gutted that I didn't bring my book, because it would have been a great chance to read, but instead I napped, chilled, and had some baobab juice. This is a really lovely beach, right? This is crazy, like the gems that you find when going for a little walk.
I was living by myself, I was walking on sandy streets every single day. Cows by my left, donkeys on my right, completely unleashed. So I guess I was pushed to the forefront of being taken out of my comfort zone. But the people there embraced me as if I was Gambian myself.
We met you when you were already gone, but we super, super, super love you already, praying for you all the time, yeah? May God be with you.
Oh my God! Learning the local languages came really handy when it came to taking taxis, haggling, or going to your local supermarkets. There are lessons that I would say I took from my experience there that I would take with me everywhere. So Senegal, I would say, is the place that really tested me as a traveller. I think there's always going to be that one place where at any point you could have cracked, but you continued. Whether it was the language barrier, so many people coming up to me, assuming I was there, and me immediately have to say back, je parle français un peu. So after a stressful day in Senegal, I headed to the beach, because it's not something that I can do in my day-to-day life. Ended up meeting with really amazing people from the States. Mid-conversation, a lizard decides to find its way down my face. And to be honest with you, I think it just shows the world of traveling in general. You never know what's gonna creep up. So how are you gonna respond to it? You have to be tenacious. You have to get on with it. And you have to just keep moving. Because I think during so many of these barriers that we face as travelers, it's all part of the journey and growth as to why I decided to do it in the first place. So Senegal, despite the little bit of dramas, I still got to embrace so much of your beauty, and I'm so grateful for it. I'm here in the buzzing and beautiful city called Lagos, which is in Nigeria. Now, for those of you who wondered, my family are originally Nigerian. My parents were born and raised in a beautiful city called Ibadan, which is very close to Lagos as well. And there's no other place that I would want to end this beautiful six-month Pan-African adventure. Nigeria is actually the country that I visited the most in my life. The first time I went, I was little as 3 months old. I've worked here. I have a really great network here. And to be honest with you, being here is what initially spurred my interests and passions to want to spend more time in my beautiful motherland and continent. Now, when deciding to move to West Africa, there's many things that you have to leave at the door. That's every expectation that you're thinking of, especially as a Westerner. So there will be things that you have to get used to. Not having stable internet all the time, language barriers, a ridiculous load of mosquito bites, and power cuts at any given time of the day. That's right, guys. I love to document things, the good, the bad, and the ugly. So mosquito bites were not a nice thing to endure over these past 6 months. I've got bitten in very awkward and uncomfortable places. It's left a lot of marks too. But I like to resemble that with my strength and willpower to literally just keep going. And if anything, it justified me wanting to stay there longer, knowing that a few scabs did not get in the way. Internet was also really annoying, and I guess it teaches me about how patient I had to be considering the fact that I was working remotely. I have never dialed *#5199234* star so many times in my life to simply get things like data, having to walk to stores to top up my data, thanking God every time that I saw Wi-Fi. Lots of patience, very, very irritating, but got through it. And do not get me started on power cuts. Oh my goodness, power cuts is one of the most biggest character building things that you can ever endure. Power cuts, I shall not miss you, but again, you really trained my character. Thank you for joining me on probably the biggest experience and journey and trip that I've taken in my life. Now, I want to leave you with one question. What next step can you take to take you closer to where you want to be? Just think about it or try it.